Intellectual property laws comprises of a wide range of areas, starting from copyright, trademarks, patents. There is media laws as an application of intellectual property laws, and there could be others like designs and trade secrets, traditional knowledge. Designs and traditional knowledge has very less application in India currently. So major parts are copyright, trademark, and patent. Now, media laws is a specific industry sector in which a particular aspect of copyright law primarily applies. And there are statutory regulations which are applicable to different modes like television, radio, over-the-top content, or like internet apps. They have specific industry models, so contracts are done in a separate way with them. So there is a media contract part, and there is a statutory regulations aspect, and then the third part is disputes relating to media laws. So all these three are specific applications of contracts and intellectual property law around copyright primarily. Okay, now this is what media laws covers, and we cover media laws in the full diploma in intellectual property rights. So those of you who want to study for 12 months and have a immersive, intense intellectual property mastery, you should look at a 1-year diploma. But for those who want to specifically delve deeper into media laws only, so for them, the course on media and entertainment laws, which has coverage on contracts, statutory regulations, and disputes, that is recommended. So nowadays, if we look at how the industry has been maturing, media and entertainment law work has increased in a big way since 2011, and off late because of the real increase in over-the-top content and apps like Amazon Prime, Netflix, and now people are going into regional language, music and video related apps. So this work is expanding a lot. Now, who are the players who need this? Okay, companies need in-house counsels to negotiate or do these deals for them. So for contracts or any statutory compliance related work, even when disputes arise. So a lot of the work right now happening around has been on contracts, but disputes have started to arise. So the part around disputes has started to arise on a lot more common basis than earlier. Okay, so earlier you would largely have copyright related litigation, but now there are more contract related disputes that are coming up. Apart from in-house counsels, there are technology and media teams of law firms, and now law firms are having dedicated and exclusive media law teams only, not technology, media and telecom teams, but exclusive media and entertainment teams to deal with these kinds of issues. In addition, there are dedicated media and entertainment law practices. These are niche boutique firms exclusively dealing with media and entertainment laws. So it's not a full service law firm, it's just a media and entertainment law practice. Okay, so this is the third major career opportunity that you can have in this area. And of course, as an independent practitioner also, you can keep getting this kind of work. So one thing important here is that you have to know how the media industry works and how a TV show or music, songs, albums, or a movie, first how it is created and how it is distributed. So you'll have to know how the producer, director, screenplay writer, the actors, how they work together to produce a movie, and then how the remaining distribution chain comes into the picture for the distribution and sales of the movies. Okay, so once you have this commercial picture in your mind, after that there's a bunch of different kinds of contracts that you need to draft. So the contracts are very focused on these kind of issues only, and these are different from a regular, let's say, a consultancy agreement or a regular marketing agreement or a regular employment agreement. These are quite different. because of the unique nature and needs of this industry. The other part one needs to know about is copyright law, and media industry is one of the places where copyright law has its most abundant application. So copyright law around music, songs, videos, this is very important, and we haven't seen such detailed and complex applications of copyright law elsewhere as is happening in the media and entertainment industry. So the contracts are very different. There are many unique clauses in each contract, and the contracts are specific to this industry. It will not be the same as a general contract. So a general distribution agreement and a movie distribution agreement will have different kind of rights. Yeah, so what we are saying is that the requirement for lawyers who are skilled in this area is increasing, and you could exclusively work on this area, or if you are a freelancer, then this could be one of the areas you work on. We have done a full deep dive into the industry and the various kinds of contracts it requires, and the people teaching are actually working on these issues. So they are able to sort of contribute their expertise and insights on actual issues that are faced at work, and the exercises you solve in the course are abstractions of that. Okay, so that is why I would say, and you are not just learning that this is the statute. We are not concerned just with what the statute is or what the case law says. And we won't just show you the contracts. We will actually make you draft them, and we will coach you on them. So every week when students submit their assignments, we give them inline feedback, interact changes, explaining them how they can improve their drafting skills. Okay, so that is how this is a very unique way to learn this subject. So that's all from my side. To know more about the course, you can click on the link of the course below in the description window or in the description area. And cheers, and see you. Let us know if you have any specific questions. We'd be happy to answer them here.